Hello there guys, it's Toad Peregrine 4 here with another Space Engineers video. I'm really cranking these things out, to be honest with you. I'm really enjoying the Let's Play. So the first thing on the list of things to do is we are going to design ourselves our very own mining ship. Let's see what we need. We are going to need let's just jump into it, I guess. So, what color do we want this guy to be? I think we want it to be yellow. Nice and ugly. There we go. So let's get some things in our bar. We're going to need blocks. We're going to need drills. I'm thinking maybe just one large cargo container, although we might end up going with like two or three medium ones. This guy is going to have a cockpit, just a working cockpit. I suppose before we attach the drills, so let's see here. So three of the faces of this guy are large cargo ports. Okay. It's not ideal. I'd prefer it to be four, but what can you do? Let's grab some interior plates while we're here. We're going to end up needing more of those. I just feel it. What's on the medium one? Let's try a medium one for now. So we'll start with a base of just a 5x5. Again, this is just to keep the thing from tipping over while we're working on it. So we're gonna go two medium cargo containers, one on top of the other. Let's have the vents or the access ports running like that. Alright. Should have been paying more attention. So the large port's right there. So we'll go ahead and put our cockpit. We'll put our cockpit right there. What else? It's gonna have to get hooked up separately, but I would like a large reactor to power this thing. It will stress our resources a little bit, but hopefully not so much that we can't deal with it. But I really do think it's worth going for it. We need 95 reactor components. That's a good few. Let's see. What can we do about that? So, to start off, we've got only 9. And we need 95. So we need, let's just go ahead and make 100 of them. Just so we have a few extras. So we do need iron. So we're probably going to have to disassemble maybe 200 small steel tubes, because I do think I overmade those a little bit. Let's go ahead and drop 200 of these bad boys in there. Get some iron. What else do we need for gravel and silver? I don't think we have hardly any gravel, but we already have the silver, I think. Let's actually get to refining a bit more. And hope hopefully in a second here. So out of silver already. That's troublesome. Well, it's not too big of a deal. We can have the reactor not go complete for a while. Let's just make the other stuff for now. Even though I'm a little bit nervous about that. Alright. So, I think we need about 10 displays. I know we need 30 bulletproof glass. Let's grab 30 or so motors. And then whenever we can fit up construction components, apparently. Computers. Don't forget the computers. More construction components and computers. Yeah, once we have this guy up and running, it should increase our capacity to get material by a lot. Which will be pretty helpful. What did I need? 3 of these and 9 of these, if I remember correctly. Well, we can only fit one. Oh, that is a beautiful yellow. Definitely not atrocious to look at. Definitely not. Oh, that's not good. Man. I've got to admit, that's not great. No matter. Let's just start over, I guess. What's the harm? This guy come up right off the back. Yeah. Yeah. That should work out nicely. Grab the medium cargo container. We're going just like that. Cockpit right on the face, and reactor. Facing just like that. Perfect. And now it won't tip. Probably. Now, we are mostly going to be using, small atmospheric thrusters for this, just because we don't quite have the material for large, and I don't think this guy really warrants it. But I am going to have to take it kind of easy, especially during the early flights, not to overload it, because I really don't want this guy to tip or not be able to get off the ground, because that would be bad. That'd be very, very bad. Yeah, I got a little bit of feedback. And I was told I got distracted easily, which is probably a fair accusation. My thought process in this game is kinda just address things as they come up. And when stuff is sort of constantly happening, like especially, you know, at first when we were landing, it was a little bit hard for me to stay focused. Just because of, first of all, the kind of crash. Oh, you know what we could do for power on the space, actually, is a windmill. Yeah, if I forget to finish a sentence, though, I'd probably get back to it at some point. Again, I may not, but hopefully I do in a somewhat timely manner, but I do my best. Alright, so I was originally going to put the drills facing downward on the bottom of this guy, but I'm not convinced that that's the right approach. Just because this thing's gotten somewhat elongated, which is not ideal. But what do the ports look like on these drills? Okay, so we've got one on the back and one on each side. So if we do that, does that obstruct the view? No, not really. Okay, that's not too shabby then. Okay. And that means we should be able to put another one. Are these things 3x3? Is that what they are? Oh, they are 3x3. Oh, that's a shame. It's kind of annoying. I thought they were 3x2. On the footprint. Well, I guess that does kind of make it easier, because then we can do... Well, we have to hook up to this reactor somehow. Yeah, when I thought it was too thick, I thought it would hook up to the reactor very nicely, but it doesn't. Here, it's going to be quite that easy, which is a little bit unfortunate. maybe we could go electric, but I really don't want this thing to get stranded because we went mining for a while. Well, how about this? Let's go ahead and get our conveyors. Is there the one that I can scroll through the variants? Because I find that's really useful for conveyors specifically. small conveyor tube, conveyor tube. I don't see it. Oh well, we don't really need this stuff anyway. Alright, so... oh, that's freaky. Alright, so we're gonna need that guy. And that. Boom, just like that. So if we do that, then we should be able to put one drill on here, then another drill on there. Those should both be connected. Okay. Let's see if we can make some more reactor components since we've been refining up the silver. We have not refined up very much silver. That is unfortunate. What are we missing? iron mostly. Actually, I think we might just be missing iron. Yeah. Okay. Well, we can disassemble some more small steel tubes. That's no problem. Let's maybe get 300 this time. Yeah, we don't need that many. But it does look like we're going to have the reactor components we need for sure, which is definitely nice. That had me a little bit nervous. Yeah, we still need to put thrusters on this guy, which I have a suspicion that the thrusters are going to give me a little bit of trouble. I don't know why these conveyors use interior plates. Very strange to me. But let's go ahead and get our large steel tubes. Alright. Let's go ahead and grab some more reactor components. And did we grab interior plates? No, we did not. We can fit one. Cool. Well, you know, make every ship count. Yeah, thrusters are gonna be troublesome, I think. If I keep on building, this thing's gonna flip again. So let me go ahead and just extend out our little platform again. Hopefully it still doesn't flip, but it might. Now, we do actually need a air vent in this guy, so that way we can breathe. Because I hear breathing's kind of nice. Oh, this guy looks different. Why is the frame red? Oh, that's kind of crazy. That's weird. It's still red. Am I using one that's supposed to be modded? Oh, no, it turned white. Let me stop wasting hydrogen. Alright, and a metal grid and some more reactor components, actually. Didn't I throw out one of these guys? That was stupid of me. Let's grab 10 more interior plates and some more reactor components. Oh, we, assembled all of our reactor components. Very nice. There we go. Large reactor. Oh, isn't that adorable? Although, arguably, I have it oriented incorrectly, but whatever. I think to make this guy fit well, okay. So we're not going to have this guy angled up or down too much, so you don't have to worry about upwards thrusters. But we do definitely have to worry about side-to-side thrust. That actually has me kind of nervous. So let's get rid of the drills for now and grab atmospheric thrusters. So while we're here, let's not forget... well, those are angled the wrong direction. What was I saying? Let's not forget gyroscopes. I don't know if I actually said that or not. I've either at least said it once or said it twice, so. doubt we have the resources to afford them. I don't really remember what all they take, but it would be nice to maybe get some shield generators. To help protect from incidental bangs and bumps. That has me a little bit worried. These are expensive. Metal grids, motors, construction components. Yikes. We do have quite a few metal grids that we can probably tear down. Metal grids, motors, construction components. Okay. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Motors, some steel plates, and large steel tubes. Let's get that guy filled up. Metal grids. Oh, can I fit some more steel plates? Let's put maybe 40 of these guys back, although I'm going to use a lot of them. But I need this guy to fill up, please. There we go. Yeah, hopefully once we have this base built, we can have some dedicated building vessels to help with construction, because if you haven't picked up on it, building in this game can be a little on the slow side. These atmospheric thrusters look so good. I love the little vents on the side, or not, I guess they're not vents, but I don't know, I love all the new details that are on them. They just look so good. So good. Let's see. So with how much those thrusters stick out, I feel like we need to have some side drills, maybe. Seems like a good call. Although that will add weight. I think I'll fix it if it presents itself as a problem. For now, I'm just going to roll with it and if I get punished for that, I get punished for that. So I want 3 gyroscopes, so that way this thing stays maneuverable. Even when it's loaded down, although gyroscopes do weigh a lot as well. Steel plates, motors, computers. Energy's kinda low, but let's grab maybe 20 steel plates. 20 computers, 20 motors. I know I said the last two backwards. It all works out in my head, I promise. I need more steel plates, clearly. Let me just grab 100 of the bad boys. There we go. Yeah, so this base isn't going to stay just green. At some point I'm going to paint it to detail a little bit, but yeah, have no fear, it's not going to be this for forever. During the last episode where I was base building, towards the beginning, I did upgrade my welder, which you may have picked up on. We were actually, because we found silver, able to get all the way up to the second highest tier, which is pretty sweet. Alright, so let's see. I'm just doing this temporarily. This isn't permanent. This is just to keep them from falling off as I grind this down on this side. Our energy is super, super low. Warning, suit energy critically low. Well, why don't you do something about it? How about that, suit? Alright, we're actually going to go do something about it. Yeah. This buggy is really good at charging up my suit. That's mostly what it's been doing. Alright, back to work we go. So now that we have those thrusters there, we should be able to remove these blocks. And not have this other side fall off. Which seems important to me. There we go. Alright, and now if we take this down, nothing's fallen off yet. That's a good sign. Nice. We might go a couple more, just because we really do want a lot of downward thrust. We do not want this guy falling if it gets loaded up. So we have left, right, forwards, backwards. Perfect. Seems like a good pattern. This thing's honestly pretty close to being finished. We will need a docking point on our pod to help dump resources. That's what this connector on the back is for. So we don't have to manually go through and move resources by hand. What are we, peasants? I think not. We've got a few more things we can load up a little bit. Just so we can dump our inventory and get as much of some of this larger stuff as possible in one trip. Curious what the power consumption of this guy is going to be. Honestly, it shouldn't be too big of a deal considering we can go and get uranium in mass now. Assuming this guy takes off. Which, it's been a little while since I've designed a in-atmosphere miner. It's noticeably easier. We don't actually need that. To build ones intended for space. What else do we need? I know we need motors, but there's no way I'm going to have enough inventory. Maybe computers? Oh, we can't really fit in anyway. Alright. Yeah, mining in space, I mean, you have to get to space first, but once you're there, oh man, the resources. It can take a little while to get to the resources, because generally speaking, you have to, you know, travel between asteroids, rather than, you know, just collecting nearby pockets. I mean, you may have to go, you know, 10, 15 kilometers to get to the pockets you need, but there's so much more of it just readily available, and it's usually a lot more exposed as well, which is pretty nice. But this guy is really close to being complete. it will be noticeably slower than our little scouting ultralight that we have. But that shouldn't be too big of a deal because we're not looking to go nearly as far with it. And really what we're looking for is something that can move with lots of cargo and not fall out of the sky. I'd really appreciate it if this didn't fall out of the sky. That's just seems like something that's important to me. Alright, more motors. What do we need, maybe 80 more? I'll grab 100 just to be safe. Ooh, hoo, hoo. Hopefully we don't need more than that. Oh, we actually might because of those guys. This has me a little nervous. Yeah, we'll want to set up a script on here as well to help us monitor our cargo space and weight. Just because we really don't want to overload. The new block models just look so industrious. Okay, this has me nervous. So we still need about 40 motors just on that one side. We should be able to tear down some power cells to make what we need, but we do need motors. So, what do motors take? Iron and nickel. And batteries are nickel, silicon, and iron. So let's disassemble maybe 100 battery components, since we actually do have uranium. Honestly, we'll probably be able to... What was that, 66 of them? So we still need to put 44 in. Yeah. What was I saying? Because we have access to uranium now, and what I feel is fairly reliable, we may want to disassemble most of the power cells for now. Can we access this port? No. It's unfortunate. This guy is looking good so far. I mean, kind of basic, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. What can we see? So if we tuck a little display, maybe like right there. Now, can we not place that? Okay, we need steel plates. So what we need for this is we need a timer block, a programmable block, and a text display. Text panel. That's what it's called. Displays, computers, components, plates. Okay. So let's grab 20 steel plates, 20 computers, 20 construction components, 20 interior plates, and our displays. That should be more than enough stuff. So, what we're looking for is we're looking for a light armor block. Our helmet's on. Whoops. A text panel. Okay, it's even the right way around. A timer block right there. Perfect. Let's grab a small battery as well, just because honestly we're gonna need the battery just to get uranium into the reactor, because the conveyor system doesn't work without a little bit of power and the programmable block. Why do I need large cell tubes for a programmable block? What is that? Let's switch to assembling. So we're about to run out of nickel. We should have some nickel built up. Yes. But how much? Oh, a fair bit of nickel, actually. It's the iron that we're really low on. But hopefully that's enough motors. I think it should be. Yeah, that should be enough motors. Why do we need large steel tubes for a programmable block? That's just silly. And I know we need two power cells. Let's grab maybe 5 kilograms of uranium. As soon as this battery is built, we're going to go ahead and dunk our uranium in the reactor. Very nice. Alright, looking very nice. Now we need a bunch of motors. Should be more than enough. Oh, we're also going to need a couple of spotlights, and an ore detector. I actually don't know where I'm going to fit those things, to be honest. We've got a little bit of room right here. We'll see. We'll see. I'll figure something. Oh, or I might be able to put it. Okay, an ore detector can go right there. Let's actually go ahead and place that right now. We don't have any of the things. Alright, good to know. But we do have the things to find out. If this thing will fly. So let's find the air vent, alright, and then we're going to set this guy to depressurize, and that will start to suck air in, and it should mean that the cockpit's now pressurized. Now, okay. Cool, we have flight. We have forwards, we have backwards, we have left, we have right. Very nice. Lots of gyro power. It says that text panel's offline. I'm not sure why that is. It says we have an hour, with our 5 kilograms of uranium, it says we have an hour, just about, of flight time. Alright, let's go ahead and set up our drills there. Alright. And we should be able to go ahead and cut the support. Perfect. That's very nice, very nice. Very, very good. Okay. So, now let's go ahead and place the ore detector, just like that. Perfect. Computer construction component, detector component. I know we only need one of these guys. Perfect. does this guy say he's offline? Maybe because he's not doing anything? It should say online, though. That baffles me a little bit. But let's go ahead and get a spotlight. We put this guy right here. Shouldn't be in the way. One interior plate. All right. Very nice, very nice. All right, so let's go ahead and put these, what are we going to call this guy? Let's go with the dirt dauber, which you may not be familiar with what that is. At least from where I'm from, dirt dauber is like some sort of wasp or hornet or something that burrows into, that like, or sorry, not burrows into, makes nests out of dirt and hunts spiders. Alright, text panel. So we're going to go ahead and set up that script as well. So let's go ahead and call that LCD. Timer block, we're going to call LCD loop. Gonna go ahead and make that bad boy silent. Programmable block. LCD driver. Perfect. The loop, we're going to have it run and trigger now and start, just like that. Perfect. in the LCD driver, we're going to use MM Master's wonderful automatic LCD script. All right. So now if we trigger that guy, why this text panel is not working. It still says it's offline. Very strange. Very, very strange. But we don't need to see those cargo containers. we don't really need to see these drills, to be honest. This guy drill straight down without falling over? Yes, yes he can. Alright, so what we're going to go ahead and do now is we're going to set up a docking port. Honestly, probably right here for now. So what do we need for a connector? Uh, 150 steel plates, 20 computers. Eight motors. 12 small steel tubes. And 40 construction components. Just like that. So now, whoops, I'm going to set this guy to switch lock, and we should be able to dock on this connector. Nice and gentle. There we go. Perfect. Let's go ahead and put these thrusters on a group. There we go. So now we want to take off. We just hit that and pull away. Perfect. 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 Well, we're going to go ahead and give this guy his maiden voyage and get some iron. And see how it does. This is actually pretty fast empty, which is nice. But we do have to be cautious. We're not going to be able to follow our old tunnel down. So we're going to try maybe going in at this angle. We are getting a little bit of shake from the drill, so it isn't the end of the world. But we're getting there. Then we're not going to be mining with like the left click mode, which, you know, as you know, picks stuff up until we're actually to the iron, because we don't need nearly this much stone, but we do want an extra large hole for this guy to fit through. Again, I'm nervous that if we do too steep of a of an incline, so I see a little bit of iron there, but we really want to get into the thick of it. Alright. So I'm going to clear a little bit of space for me to maneuver around here by digging out to my right. Actually, not sure how long this episode's been going on for. Hopefully it's not too long. But, yeah, there we go. So now we should have enough room to actually maneuver around in here. And we can go ahead and start mining. Let's check our inventory. So we actually haven't started to fill up the cargo containers at all. For some reason, why are we not able to move stuff into the cargo containers? That is rather worrisome. Yeah, stuff doesn't appear to be going into the cargo containers. And I don't know why. Can I move stuff into either cargo? No, I cannot. Why are we not connected to the cargo containers? We should be able to pull through the cockpit, because the cockpit has a connector on the back. Or at least I thought it did. Well, we do have some iron. We have a fair bit. We have more than one load, and that's just stored in the drills. Or one load previously. So I guess we'll run back to base and figure out why we're not connected. Yeah, a little on the sluggish side now, but still pretty good, pretty responsive. Well, that's funny. If you look at the back of the spotlight model, it has like a what looks like a place to like plug in for power. That's neat. I'm not sure why that display's not working either. That's also bothering me. for right now, what I'm really worried about is why this thing isn't connected. Let me see, let's look at the cockpit model. Oh, the cockpit model has two small connections on the back, not one large one. Oh man, that's a pain. Oh, it has one large connection on the bottom. Not on the back. Ah. Well, that's downright awful. How can we remedy this? Ideally, we could put it, if we were to put a gap here, we could just run from the reactor down to here. but that's not terribly convenient. I don't really want to tear this guy down just for that. If I break that, is this going to fall off? I think so. So let's see. What do we need? We need interior plates, construction components, motors. Okay, okay. Interior plates, construction components, and motors. That's what we need. Let's actually get rid of this block on our base. We need to upgrade our grinder at some point. So let's go ahead and brace this so that way our drill doesn't fall off. And let's put a conveyor block here. And then put a tube running this way, and that should get it connected up. And shouldn't even ruin the look, but too much. Yeah. Then we'll put a few steel blocks around it, or a few armor blocks around it to help protect it from getting bumped into. Actually, it should be protected by the drill, actually. But we should see all of that iron in the cargo container. Very good, very good. So let's go ahead and dump our inventory again. Let's cut this brace. Alright, hop back in the seat here. Kill the thrusters and go to the refinery. Find all the iron. Alright, and we're moving through effectively. Very nice, very nice. So let's grab cargo one and dump some of our inventory. Alright. We should be good then. Yep, and the refinery is moving right on along, so let's go ahead and turn our thrusters on. Are we lifting the base some, or the pod? Looks like we are. Maybe not though, maybe I'm just nuts. Whoops, going the wrong way. But yeah, now that we have that actually working properly, let's give ourselves one more go. I know this is a bit of a longer episode, I apologize for that, but I'm pretty excited to see this thing going. This is a big step towards making things a lot faster. One thing we still need to do is actually get get refineries set up on the new base once that's moving along a little bit more. But so I'm gonna bust out this wall a little bit, actually, just to give me a little bit more room to maneuver. Should be able to just push right into this wall. I'm not sure what's going on with that LCD. It really bugs me that that's not quite working. It does look like we can actually fit just about into our drill footprint, like the whole vessel, which is definitely a plus. But so what's our mass? 117 kilograms. Whew, that is steep. I mean, look at that. Like, this is one whole load of the buggy right there in that one cargo container. And you know, both of them are filled up, as well as some overflow in the drills. And yeah, this is a big step forward. So we'll go ahead and get this back to base, and then I'm gonna end the episode. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this. We should be able to pull. Ooh, okay. Oh, we can't pull straight out of here, but we can pull at a little bit of an angle. Might have to increase my forward thrust a little bit to help with that, but that's no big deal. Yeah, look at those thrusters working hard. Yeah, that won't be too hard of a fix, though. So yeah, we'll go ahead and get docked, and then I'll end the episode. And what I'll probably do is do either a bunch of mining off camera, or do it in the next episode as a time lapse. I'm not sure. But it's getting kind of late here for now, so that'll be a decision for tomorrow. Yeah, we're a little bit boaty right now with our cargo containers completely filled up. Little bit boaty. Probably move that buggy, because it's going to actually end up getting burnt by our thrusters. If we leave it that close to where we're docking. Alright. Lock, kill the thrusters. Okay. Well, this isn't great. Not great at all. Please don't break. Please don't break stuff. Please don't break stuff. Please don't break stuff. Oh, no. Things were going so smoothly. Look at our poor buggy. How is it not getting crushed? Oh, it kinda is. Well, guess this is as good a place as any to end the episode. Probably shouldn't have hung that much weight off the end. Anyway, we'll fix this next episode. But thank you again for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.